This week on a special edition of Close Up, it's a debate here in our studios between the two candidates who want to be mayor of New Hampshire's biggest city. From economic development to education, the opioid crisis to homelessness, we'll address the major issues facing Manchester and the candidates' plans to deal with them. Incumbent Democrat Joyce Craig is seeking her second term after becoming the first woman to be elected mayor in city history in 2017. Mayor Craig was previously a Manchester City Alderman, serving in that role from 2009 to 2015. She also served a term on the Manchester School Board. She graduated from Memorial High School in Manchester before graduating from UNH.
I want to continue with what we're doing, what we've done over these last 2 years. We have tremendous momentum going. We've spent a lot of time on economic development. We've got new businesses coming into the city.
Her Republican challenger is Victoria Sullivan, a former New Hampshire state representative who served as assistant majority leader and on the House Education Committee. She has been a coach and volunteer, served as a PTA president for her children's elementary school, and on the New Hampshire PTA executive board. Sullivan also served as a select woman for Ward 9 and on the Manchester Heritage Commission. She went to Medway High School in Massachusetts and Northern Essex Community College.
It actually breaks my heart to see the city going in this direction. And like I said, I'm raising my children here. We know so many families that have abandoned the city who have left because their family comes first and they want to put their kids in a safe environment. We're not providing that at this time.
Good morning and welcome to this special edition of Close Up, Manchester Mayoral Debate Edition. I'm Adam Sexton and I'm joined this morning by WMUR political reporter John DeStaso. We'll be posing questions to the candidates, Mayor Joyce Craig and challenger Victoria Sullivan. A quick note about our format, candidates will get 1 minute each to answer questions and 30-second rebuttals will be granted at the moderator's discretion. We will also have 1 minute closing statements at the very end, but we have very limited time and we wanted to jump right into the questions and we're going to start with John DeStaso.
Good morning. Homelessness in Manchester is a significant issue. The welfare department is sounding the alarm that there's no way it will stay within its budget about 3 months into the fiscal year. Mayor Craig, you came up with a plan, said this was a top issue, but many say it's worsened. Did you underestimate it and wait too long to publicly admit the scope of the problem?
We did not. The city has been working extremely hard since I got into office. And when I did get into office less than 2 years ago, the 10-year plan to address homelessness had run out. The previous administration did not proceed with that. So one of the first things that I did was to put forward a plan to address homelessness. So it discussed affordable housing and other issues that are critical to ensuring that people get off of the streets and get the help that they need. This group encompassed nonprofits, business leaders, the faith-based communities, and we are all working in the direction of assisting individuals when we can. One of the important things to note right now is that approximately 50% of the people in Manchester who are homeless are not from Manchester. So we have been working closely with the state as well to ensure that they have appropriate housing throughout the state, because Manchester cannot solve the issue of homelessness for the state of New Hampshire.
And Mrs. Sullivan, you have partly blamed the problem on Mayor Craig, saying that by closing down homeless camps near the river and along the highways, it's led to people to seek shelter on Elm Street. Should there be sanctioned outdoor camps in city limits? Who should oversee them? And would that lead to public health problems?
So I had organizations reach out to me that said that they were working with the homeless where they were at. And when the city had the highway department come in and destroy where they were and get rid of their warm clothing, their warm boots, and their food, they moved immediately downtown because they had immediate shelter in the doorways and they had money and they had food. When I'm down at the shelters talking to people to see what we can do to help them, what their needs are, they haven't said that they want an outdoor place that the city controls. What they've said is they want better transportation to get them to the jobs that they can get to. They want better facilities so that they can wash and be clean for jobs. And we have people that are working, but because we overrode the tax cap and our property taxes go up, and again, we overrode the tax cap and those property taxes will go up again, that raises the rentals on these people that are the most vulnerable. And so if we really want to talk about affordable housing, we need to respect the tax cap and keep spending in check.
We'll keep moving on topics here. We're going to get okay. 30 seconds rebuttal.
Thank you. Just in terms of the city going in and destroying camps along the river, that's not an accurate statement. What happens is that individuals may call and mention that there is a camp on private property, and what the city does, we have a team put together of first responders, of individuals from nonprofits who can help these individuals who are in the camps, and the health department, and they go and check the camps to ensure that they are safe from a public health perspective and a public safety perspective. At no point in time are these camps destroyed. They're given notice if there's an issue, and they are asked to move on.
Thank you, Mayor Craig. 30 seconds.
Yeah, so the organizations that work with these people came directly to me and said that is not what happened. In fact, things were destroyed in front of these people that were given to them by the organizations. So if that is, in fact, what the protocol is supposed to be, it didn't happen, and these people were displaced. We've all seen it downtown. We see that they're living downtown. And I've spent time sitting with them, talking to them, and received stories from them that back up what the organizations have said to me.
Thank you. We're going to keep moving here to the topic of crime. Ms. Sullivan, Representative Sullivan, on your website, you say, quote, crime is spiking dramatically in Manchester. Crime statistics comparing the first 9 months of last year to this year show violent crime is up 5%, but property crime is down 9%. Is it fair to call that a spike?
It is, because when I'm out speaking to people, a lot of people have stopped calling to report littler crimes, littler thefts, like when people rummage through their car and take things, because they don't feel like there'll ever be an outcome, there won't be a resolution, and they won't get their property back. So I think that we've stopped reporting some of the smaller crimes, but as I said repeatedly, I would rather someone stole my purse than attacked my person. And we have seen violent crime increase and homicides increase, and that's not acceptable. It can't be our new normal. And trying to, you know, switch the facts, that the fact is that people don't feel safe going downtown. They don't feel like they can go down there and enjoy the evening. And if they're not going to enjoy themselves, they're not going to be spending money in our city.
Mayor Craig, the numbers are what they are, but there is a perception, not just in the city, but outside the city, that crime is a serious problem in Manchester. How do you respond to that?
Sure. Crime and preventing crime and working with the police department is my number one priority. And the fact of the matter is, crime is down in Manchester by 6%. Yes, there have been spikes in certain areas that you've noted, but those certain areas, there have been spikes throughout the entire state, to the point where the AG's office has said that this could be a historical number of homicides throughout the state, and they're actually asking for more individuals to be hired to handle this. So as a result, we have been working hard to make sure people do feel safe in our city. We have hired 15 additional police officers. We've increased patrol in our downtown and throughout the city. We have funded body cameras for our police officers, and I work closely every day with the chief of police and the Manchester Police Department to ensure they have the resources needed to make sure that our community, our residents, and our visitors are safe in Manchester.
Representative Sullivan, 30 seconds.
And so if crime is decreasing and people feel safe in the city, then there wouldn't be a need to all of a sudden implement 15 new officers. We, from the day that Tim Baines took his seat as an alderman, he started talking about these situations. He was very clear about what it needed to happen and what was happening downtown. It took 18 months for the city to respond to his concerns.
Mayor, 30 seconds.
Thank you. That's not accurate. It hasn't taken 18 months. It's almost been the time that I've been in office. I just want to say a couple things. Call volume is up to the Manchester Police Department. One of the things that I've consistently said and asked our community to do is to call the police if they see someone breaking the law. We have zero tolerance for anyone breaking the law. So when call volume is increasing, we need to address that and make sure we have adequate staff in the police department, which is why we approved hiring additional police officers and also why we approved increasing patrol in downtown.
Thank you, Mayor Craig. Next question from John DeStaso.
And we'll turn to education. Mayor, you've made education a top priority in your last campaign. What concrete achievements can you point to on that front? Can you make improvements without more spending and higher taxes? And if so, how?
Sure. Education has always been a priority from my perspective, and I believe that we need strong public schools in order to succeed as a city. I worked with the college and university system, and we applied for and received a $10.5 million grant, the Gear Up grant. So that's a significant investment in our city. I'm working with Manchester Proud, again, a group of business leaders who are investing significantly into the city to put a strategic plan in place. We've seen graduation rates at West High School increase by 10 points. When you look at third grade reading, 58% of our third graders at the end of last year's school year are proficient in language arts. We have implemented a math curriculum this year, and the superintendent is recommending that we have a reading curriculum, standard reading curriculum from K to 8th grade next year, which I completely support.
Representative Sullivan? A question from John.
You're used to running the show, Adam.
Representative Sullivan, as a state rep, you were a champion of school choice. Will you advocate for public funding for private schools as mayor? And what steps will you take in terms of policy to expand charter schools and school choice in general?
Thank you. So I think that there's a misconception that school choice strictly means taking children out of public schools and putting them into private schools, and it doesn't. It means finding the education that best suits that child. That could be homeschool, that could be a public charter school, that could be moving from the school that they're told they have to go to based on their zip code to a school that better suits them, still a public school in the city. I did advocate for SB 193, which was the school choice bill, which would have allowed people to have some of their tax dollars back to invest in their children's education should they have chosen private school. And I will tell you that it was the middle and middle lower class families that really reached out and wanted support of that. This mayor actually sent a letter not supporting that. And I believe that every child should have the best opportunity they can for their lives, regardless of where they live by zip code.
Mayor, you were invoked. A quick response.
Thank you so much. I agree that parents need to make the decision for what's best for their child from a school perspective. But given the financial constraints that we are under in our city and within our school district, I do not agree with taking taxpayer dollars, public dollars, and putting that money to private schools, which is why I went.
Response from Representative Sullivan.
Yeah, so it's always the taxpayers' money, right? So the taxpayers are paying money to send their children to school, and they should have some control over that money so that they can send their child to the school that best suits them.
All right, we've covered a lot of ground so far. We want to cover a lot more. Stay with us. When we come back, we'll continue with our Manchester mayoral debate.